Let us join together in prayer. Father, we remember today the pain and suffering of the cross and all that you were willing to endure so that we could be set free. You paid the price, such a great sacrifice, to offer us the gift of eternal life. Help us never to take for granted this huge gift of love on our behalf. Help us to be reminded of the cost of it all. Forgive us for being too busy or distracted by other things, not fully recognizing what you have freely given, what you have done for us. Thank you, Father, that by your wounds we are healed. Thank you that because of your huge sacrifice we can be set free. Thank you that sin and death have been conquered and your power is everlasting. Thank you that we can say with great hope, it is finished, for we know what's still to come. And death has lost its sting. We praise you, Father, that you are making all things new. In your holy name we say, amen.
Reading tonight is from Matthew 27, 2 through 11. And when they had bound him, they led him away and delivered him to Pontius Pilate, the governor. Then Judas, his betrayer, seeing that he had been condemned, was remorseful and brought back the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and elders, saying, I have sinned by betraying innocent blood. And they said, what is it to us? You see to it. Then he threw down the pieces of silver in the temple and departed and went and hanged himself. But the chief priests took the silver pieces and said, it is not lawful to put them into the treasury because they are the price of blood. And they consulted together and bought with them the potter's field to bury strangers in. Therefore, that field has been called the field of blood to this day. Then it was fulfilled what was spoken by Jeremiah the prophet, saying, "And they took the 30 pieces of silver, the value of him who was priced, whom they of the children of Israel priced, and gave them for the potter's field, as the Lord had directed me." Now Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him, saying, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus said to him, "It is as you say."
Our second reading is from Matthew 27, verses 27 through 31 and 33 through 35. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the praetorium and gathered the whole garrison around him. And they stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him. When they had twisted a crown of thorns, they put it on his head and a reed in his right hand. And they bowed their knee before him and mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews." Then they spat on him, took the reed, and struck him on the head. And when they had mocked him, they took the robe off him, put his own clothes on him, and led him away to be crucified. And when they had come to the place called Golgotha, that is to say, the place of a skull, they gave him sour wine mingled with gall to drink. But when he tasted it, he would not drink. Then they crucified him and divided his garments, casting lots, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, "They divided my garments among them, and for my clothing they cast lots."
Third reading is Matthew 27, 45 to 46. Now from the sixth hour until the ninth hour, there was darkness over all the land. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, saying, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani," that is, my God, why have you forsaken me?"
Upon the way. Okay,
1, 2, 3. Oh, say the now.
There's no reading.
Turn the other page. The other way.
Well, I have it in my purse. Says, then Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do. I'm going to read Luke chapter 23, verse 43. And Jesus said to him, assuredly, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise.
This reading is from John 19, 26 through 27. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing by, he said to his mother, Woman, behold your son. Then he said to the disciple, Behold your mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her to his own home.
Crucified.
I'll be reading from Matthew 27, 46. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? That is, my God, why have you forsaken me?
I'll be reading John 19, verse 28. After this, aware that everything was now finished, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled, Jesus said, I thirst.
I'll be reading from John 19, verse 30. So when Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, It is finished. And bowing his head, he gave up his spirit.
Suffered and bled.
The last reading is from Luke 23:46. And when Jesus had cried out with a loud voice, he said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." Having said this, he breathed his last.
Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.